Now, let's talk about trigonometric functions of an acute angle. So there are six trigonometric functions. So these are the sine, the cosine, the tangent, the cosecant, the secant, and the cotangent. So suppose we have this right triangle on the right. Angle C is the 90 degree angle, and angle A and angle B are its two acute angles. Now, side C is the hypotenuse. The hypotenuse is the longest side of the right triangle, and that is always opposite the 90 degree angle, while the sides A and the side B are its two other legs. Now, the sine theta is equal to the opposite over the hypotenuse. The cosine theta is equal to adjacent over the hypotenuse. The tangent theta is equal to opposite side over the adjacent side. The cosecant theta is equal to the hypotenuse over the opposite side. The secant theta is equal to the hypotenuse over the adjacent side. And the cotangent theta is equal to adjacent side over the opposite side. So let us find the six trigonometric functions of angle B. So angle B is our theta. So sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So the opposite side of the theta is B, or side B, and the hypotenuse is C, so that is B over C. Now the cosine theta is equal to the adjacent over the hypotenuse, so the adjacent side of this is A, and the hypotenuse is C, so that is A over C. Now the tangent, so the tangent theta is equal to the opposite over the adjacent. So this is the opposite, this is the adjacent, so that is B over A. Now the cosecant theta is equal to hypotenuse over the opposite. So this is the hypotenuse, this is the opposite, so that is C over B. Now the secant theta is equal to the hypotenuse, this is the hypotenuse, and the adjacent is A, so that is C over A. And the cotangent theta is equal to the adjacent side over the opposite side. So cotangent is equal to A over B. Now let's have this example number one. So find the six trigonometric functions of the theta for the triangle given below. So the hypotenuse is unknown. So let us find first the hypotenuse. Suppose this is our A, this is our B, and this is our C. So the hypotenuse is unknown. So using the Pythagorean theorem, the formula is C squared is equal to A squared plus the B squared. Now the C squared is C is unknown. So we have A is equal to 3, so this is 3 squared, plus B is 4, so this is 4 squared. Now C squared is equal to 3 squared is 9, plus 4 squared is 16. Now C squared is equal to 9 plus 16 is 25. Now to solve for the C, raise both sides of the equation by 1 half or simply get its square root. So cancel this. C is equal to the square root of 25 is 5. So the hypotenuse is 5. Okay, so let us find now the six trigonometric functions of this right triangle below. Okay, so the sine that is opposite over the hypotenuse. So if this is the theta, the opposite side is 3 and the hypotenuse is 5. So sine theta is equal to 3 over 5. Now the cosine is equal to adjacent over the hypotenuse. So the adjacent is 4 and the hypotenuse is 5. So cosine theta is 4 over 5. Now the tangent theta is equal to the opposite over the adjacent. So this is the opposite, 3, and the adjacent is 4. So that is 3 over 4. Now for the cosecant, that is hypotenuse over the opposite. So just get the reciprocal of the sine, that is 5 over 3. Now, for the secant theta, that is hypotenuse over the adjacent. So just get the reciprocal of the cosine. So the secant theta is equal to 5 over 4. Now, the cotangent is equal to adjacent over the opposite, or just get the reciprocal of the tangent, that is 4 over 3. Now, let's have this example number 2. Find the six trigonometric functions of the theta for the given triangle. Okay, so again, the hypotenuse is unknown. So let us find first the hypotenuse. So suppose this is our A, this is our B, and this is C. So C is unknown. So the formula again is C squared equals A squared plus B squared. Now, C squared is equal to A is 15, so this is 15 squared, plus b is 8, so this is 8 squared. 15 squared is equal to 225, and 8 squared is 64. Now, 225 plus 64 is 289. Now, raise both sides of this of the equation by 1/2, or simply get the square root of the both sides. So cancel this. C is equal to the square root of 289 is 17. So the hypotenuse is 17. So let us find the 6 trigonometric functions of this right triangle. So the sine again is opposite over the hypotenuse. This is our theta. So the opposite is 15 and the hypotenuse is 17. So that is 15 over 17. Now the cosine is adjacent over the hypotenuse. So this is 8 over 17. Next, the tangent, that is opposite over the adjacent. So this is 15 over 8. Now the cosecant is hypotenuse over the opposite. So the hypotenuse is 17. And the opposite is 15, or simply get the reciprocal of the sine. Same with the second theta, that is hypotenuse over the adjacent, is get the reciprocal of the cosine, that is 17 over 8, and the cotangent is adjacent over the opposite, so the adjacent is 8 and the opposite is 15, that is 8 over 15. Now let's have this example number 3. Given that theta is an acute angle, and the cosine theta is equal to 5 over 8. Find the tangent theta, B the second theta, and C the sine theta. So the first thing that we need to do is to draw the triangle. So suppose this acute angle is our theta, and we know that cosine theta is equal to adjacent over the hypotenuse. So if cosine theta is equal to 5 over 8, so meaning, the hypotenuse is 8 and the adjacent side is 5. Now, let us find the other side of this right triangle. So the formula again is C squared is equal to A squared plus the B squared. Now the C, suppose this is our A, this is our B, and this is our C. So C is 8, so this is 8 squared, is equal to A, so this is A squared, which is unknown, plus the B, which is 5, so this is a squared. Now transpose 5 on the other side. So we have 8 squared minus 5 squared is equal to A squared. Now 8 squared is 64 minus 5 squared is 25. This is equal to A squared. Now 64 minus 25, that is 39. So 39 is equal to A squared. Now again, raise both sides of the equation by 1/2, or simply get the square root of the two sides. Now A is equal to square root of 39, or this is approximately 6.24. So the A is square root of 39. Now let us find letter A, which is now the tangent theta. So we know that the tangent theta is equal to the opposite over the adjacent. So if A is equal to square root of 39, so that is the opposite of the theta, that is square root of 39 over the adjacent, which is 5. So the tangent theta is equal to square root of 39 over 5. Now let's have letter B. So letter B, let us find the second theta. So we know that the second is hypotenuse over adjacent. Now, the hypotenuse is 8 and the adjacent is 5. So therefore, the second theta is equal to 8 over 5. Now, let's find letter C. So letter C is sine theta. So sine is equal to the opposite over the hypotenuse. So the opposite is 5, is square root of 39, and the hypotenuse is 8. So the sine theta is equal to square root of 39 over 8. Thank you.